The extra hour comes from the past. You ever notice how time used to fly, but recently every day is dragging on forever? That's because we borrow time from the past. We used to take it from the early 90s, just a couple hours here and there. Then we raided the 80s and took all of 1983. We took, half of 1977, 1973, a third of 1969, and three-fifths of 1961 through 1963. Finally, America unilaterally took all of 1938 until the beginning of 1941 for itself, which is why we seem to have joined World War II later than most of the rest of the participating countries. And when it became apparent that we needed a lot more time, obviously there's 7 billion people on this planet and they all need more time, we just started pulling it wholesale from the Paleozoic and Mesozoic eras. And this is why we see so many fossils from these periods, but you never see a fossil of, for instance, a modern duck. It's because dinosaurs died and were fossilized in a matter of hours, instead of the usual millions of years the process used to take. Now, we're beginning to run out of hours we can pull from these eras, though. It's called peak time, and scientists believe we will have reached it in the next 20 years or so. We'll then have to find a way to extract time from the Precambrian, which, as everyone knows, is very difficult, even though there's a lot of time locked up there. It's hoped that one day alternative time sources can completely replace our dependence on fossil time sources. And there are a lot of promising technologies out there already, just to mention a few. The first is sidereal days, mining time from the sides of cereal boxes. The second is light years, that's extracting time directly from the sun, light bulbs, and fire. The third is Planck time, a renewable way to harvest time from plants. Unfortunately, there are powerful corporations behind the scenes who hold a great deal of sway over both the legislative system and popular opinion, who are reliant on the current outmoded and devastating practice of deep time drilling. Hopefully, we'll be able to overcome these entrenched oligarchies and completely move our time harvesting system to these alternative sources before we reach peak time. Otherwise, it'll be too late.